Hello everyone, welcome to a new Flarum live stream. And right at this time, the weather becomes loud. Okay, but I think you should hear me. There might be some background noise because today is the Swiss National Day and there might be some fireworks, but I think all my neighbors already used all their fireworks last night, so there is not any noise today so far. What we will do today, as you have seen in the description, let's switch to my screen and take a look just at this. So basically this post that I made last week on the forum is basically the whole essence of what we are going to make. We want to make, so if we take a look here, the question was how can we restrict registration to just one email domain? And basically this can be achieved by using the validator extender and adding some logic. But yeah, this has been a regular request and I was thinking it would be a good idea to make that into a standalone extension. And yeah, it's quite simple compared to other extensions. So that's why we will not only do that, we will actually add a few options. We will allow to toggle between a regular expression or not regular expression. And when we are not in regular expression mode, we will just validate the domain. And if we are in regex mode, we will validate all of the email. So yeah, that's the idea. And I also want to make the extension with both a whitelist and a blacklist so that you can choose to use one or the other. And we will also allow to set a custom error message. Yeah, that's the idea. And if you have any question about what I'm doing today or about something else in Flarum, don't hesitate to just leave a message in the chat. I have the chat on my second screen visible and I will answer if I see any question. So yeah, let's get started. There is still an extension generator, but I'm not going to use it yet, but I will try to use it in the future. I know that the official release of the Flarum client it comes soon, so yeah, we will see. But for now, I just usually copy another extension. So let's see which one can I copy. Maybe bookmarks. Yeah, let's copy bookmarks. And let's make this into the new extension. And we wait. Okay, so how are we going to name this extension? I think I will name it email whitelist. Then later we will make another extension for the username. I think the username will be called username blacklist, but in fact both extensions can be configured either as whitelist or blacklist. But yeah, I think email you will usually blackmail. No, I mean email you will usually whitelist some emails mostly. Whereas with usernames, you will usually ban some specific usernames. I don't think it will make much sense to have a username whitelist, except you might use that with a regular expression. So email whitelist, then so I have copied this other extension, so I will delete the .id and .git folders so that I can start fresh. I will also delete the log file, the node modules, and yeah, we will not have any migrations, so I can delete that as well. And resources, we will not have any less, but we will have probably a few translations. Okay, next we will open that project in PHP Storm. So let's go here. Let's find, so it is called email whitelist. Open in this window. Oh, there is some strange stuff going on with YouTube analytics. It says that all three of you just disappeared 1 minute ago and then came back. That's probably not the case, but yeah, I have some strange dips in the stats. Yeah. Ah, now it's flat again. Okay. I guess YouTube uses some kind of machine learning to decide how many people were actually watching. Maybe, I don't know. So Flahomext whitelist. We will edit composer.json with a new name, so email whitelist. Yep. Then we can add some keywords, email whitelist. We can also put blacklist. And maybe we can put validation. Okay, next, we don't need the ext.json requirement. So just Flahom core 1.0 or greater, 1.x. Author is still the same. Source, I will need to update. Source I can update with the name. It will be called email whitelist, but the forum link I will remove for now. Then the namespace will be email whitelist, and the name will be email whitelist. Yeah. Then we need an icon, so let's try to find an icon. Which one is the best? Don't know if I just put the icon for email. Maybe the at. Oh yeah, something I forgot to mention. Maybe you are wondering what the difference is with the extension we did. So we did this extension a few weeks ago. There are some similarities between those extensions. But this extension was doing an external API request, and it was a lot more complicated because it was designed for custom integrations. The one we do today is a lot simpler, but there are some common elements. And I was wondering which icon I used. Yeah, I used the at icon. Is there something that I can use for whitelist? No. There are absolutely no icons. So is there another icon I could use? Maybe one with a checkbox. Or do I just use the at? Hello, Tommy. Yeah. Oh, and now we are back to two people watching. Well, hello everyone watching live, and hello everyone watching in replay. I know some people always watch the replays. It's probably, in some sense, if you don't have a lot of time, it's probably easier to watch the replays because you can fast forward. You cannot fast forward when it's live, of course, but live you can ask questions. So I'm not finding any good icon, so I guess I don't know if I want to put the same icon on both extensions, because the other extension will be for username. I think I will use the at icon for this one, so fas fa at. Yeah, but we will see what I put for username. I might just use the same one. Yeah, okay, let's not lose too much time on this. Next, I can update my namespace, in extend.php, and I can update the README. Email whitelist. But I will do the other thing. I will update the remaining of the README later. Okay. So let's check what else we have in this extension. So lots of stuff we don't need. I don't even know if we will need an SRC folder. I will keep the folder, but we might not even use it. So the namespace will be, for translation, will be like this. And actually, thing is, there will not be any forum translations, I think. There will only be admin translations. And then in the JavaScript side, we will call this email whitelist. And actually, there will not be any forum JavaScript. Everything will be server side, but we need just some admin JavaScript just to show the settings. So yeah, like this. I want to use TypeScript to have the autocomplete. So type, how is it called? I always forget. Is it called Flarom typings? Oh no, it's tsconfig. Okay, it's this one. I'm probably better just copying from another extension. That's where the extension generator will be useful. I'll try to use it another time. So for now, I will just copy from another extension. So I will just copy tsconfig. And so what I'm copying this from another extension, but it's what is described in the Flarom documentation. So to use TypeScript, you need this file, which is based on what is on this repository, and you need to install the tsconfig. Oh, it's not even up to date here. You need to require the tsconfig, but instead of running yarn add, I will first add it to my config, and then I will run yarn install. Okay. So let's go with that, and this file will become .ts, and I can also make this one .ts. Okay, now let's go back to the folder. Let's do yarn install. Just wait a second. And then we can run the watch script with yarn dev. Okay, and let's see if we have access to the autocomplete. Maybe PHP Storm needs to index again. No, I think it's already good. So then we can add settings like this. Yeah, so for now we still have the setting for bookmarks, but we will get this sorted. Okay, so where do we start? So now we have a blank extension. It's not that blank because there is still some stuff here which I can actually remove. We don't need a lot of this. Yeah, so basically, yeah, here we have a starting point, which is just the minimal stuff required for an extension. Okay. Now, I think we will copy the code from the forum. So this was the code that I was suggesting to manually validate something. So we will put this here. I will import the user validator from Flarom. And then we are already pretty good. This I can type hint like this. And yeah, now we just need to change this into a setting and this into a setting as well. So to access the settings, we need to resolve the settings. So we can use resolve function, resolve settings repository interface from Flarom, put that in a variable. Then I will just add a type hint so PHP Storm knows what it is. And then what we can do here is regex, and here it could be a value, so settings get, and then it will just be called Clark email whitelist dot whitelist, for example. And then we can use another setting here with another setting which is error, for example, or error message. I don't know how, we will see. I will rename some stuff later. So yeah, I can do something like this. There are some problems with this. Which one of the problem is what I described in the post, is that if we do it like this, then if any other extension wants to use a regular expression, actually this will conflict because the two extensions, you can see the custom error message is based on the name of the attribute and the name of the validation rule. So if another extension uses regex, then the custom messages will conflict. So we actually will need to make a custom rule, and then we can validate using that rule. So actually it will not stay exactly like this. So yeah, what we can do then is, one of the options is what I linked in the post here, is to use just a validation callback. And I think we will use that. So if we use the validation callback, then we can do it like this. Then here the logic becomes different. Then it becomes, we will do the regular expression ourselves. So we will do preg match, use this regular expression, use the value. And then if this is different from one, we will call the fail function, and we will call the fail function with this, and we need to pass settings into the function here. Yeah, and then I can drop this and I can drop this. Now we have something that will not conflict with other extensions. We can even resolve the settings inside of here. There is no need to do it outside. Okay. So something like this, we are already pretty good to go, I think. We will create just settings. We will make it so you can edit those settings in the admin. So to do that, we go back to our admin index.ts file. And here we have just an initializer. Inside of here, we have the extension data extender. And then we just say to Flarom that, oh, I want a setting. And this has been copied from the bookmarks extension, but I can just adapt it. So what is the name of my settings? It's Clark email whitelist dot whitelist. The label will be settings dot, so that's where we will use some translations, whitelist. And the type will be text. And we can add a second setting for the error. So the other one I mean, I don't want to call it error, just I want to call it error message, but I don't really need to put the word error because there will not be any other message. So I will just call it message. And I will just change it here as well. Just call it message. And then I can add the translations here. So error message and whitelist. So yeah, I said that we would validate the domain, but for now we are just doing the whitelist. Then we are doing the regular expression. We'll change it later. Okay, let's install the extension now so we can test if anything works. So I use that name. I will go back to my Flarom here. I will not open the wrong thing. Okay, so composer require my extension name and at dev. And it works because my extension is in a workbench folder which has been configured as a local composer directory. So then when I install the at dev version, it finds it inside of the folder, and you can see it says that it uses a symlink to connect that. Okay, and now it's already okay. I mean, it should be. Let's refresh the admin panel and see if we find the extension. So it's called email whitelist. It's here and we can enable it. Okay, so we can see we have our two settings in the panel, and yeah, we will not see anything else. So now let's just try to put something. So we will validate an email at example.com. Ends with at example.com, and the error message will be nope. Okay, so let's see if it works. To test that, we will go in private browsing so that we are not logged in. And we will try to sign up. So just one last thing, I need to remove, I think I still have some code in my extended PHP. So no, it seems to have been commented out, just because I know that I had the custom extender inside of my local extended PHP. It seems like it's commented out, so it should not create issues. So then I will just use any username. I mean, I don't even need to fill a username because I can just, there will be multiple validation errors, but I can just do it like this. So we can see it says the username field is required, the password field is required. So that's normal. That's because I left them empty. But you can also see there is the word nope in between, which is the custom error message for this. And now if I use the correct domain, I don't have the nope error anymore. I have the email has already been taken. That's because I probably already created an account with that email. So you can see that now it's valid when I type something that passes the regular expression. So yeah. So basically we could already almost release this like it is now. Except we want to make it a bit more useful. So what else we want? So I want a switch to switch between a regular expression or just domain check. And I also want the list to be a text area so that I can put multiple domains and multiple regular expressions on new lines. And we want to have a blacklist feature. And I think I will make the blacklist into its own text area. That way you can use both whitelist and blacklist at the same time if you prefer to do it like this. So yeah. Oh, and there is something else we could do, but I don't know how we are going to do it. Because we could put a permission to allow admins to still use, because right now admins will also be unable to use any blacklisted domain. It would be nice if admins could change the email of an account to something that is usually not allowed without having to change the whitelist. But the problem is that we don't have access to the actor in here. So we cannot check the permission of the current user. So that check would have to happen. It would have to happen in the user saving event instead of the user validation. I'm not sure if I want to do that. So I think we will not go into that. It's just a bit too complicated. We will just add the few settings I mentioned, but not any permission. So I can already add the label. How are we going to call this? So one will be regex. So it will just be called regex. And it will enable regular expression. So let's just add this. So regex will be regular expression. Blacklist. So I'm not sure in which order I will put them. Error message, whitelist, blacklist. We will need some help texts because otherwise people might not understand it well. So, so regex help. This text will say so. By default, the white and black list will be domains in regular. Yeah, I'm not sure how to write this. Or maybe I need to put it inside of the. Or switch from domain list to regular expression check. Each line of the list must be a valid regular expression with delimiters. I think we will do it like this so that you have some idea of what you need to do. Then error message. I don't know if this one needs a help text. And then here we will have whitelist help one expression per line. And yeah, something like this, blacklist help. And then I need to have some text that says what happens if you fill both. So we'll have priority over the black list. Okay, so let's see. Oh, I need to show the help text. So I can add the help text like this. So help, regex help. And then we have white. I can add help, whitelist help. Then I will put this one here and I will put it twice. And this one will be called blacklist. And I can update this. The problem is that I think we still cannot do text areas at this time. So you can see how the settings look. I don't think we have added text area yet. Do we? No, we don't have text areas. So that's where we have some issues. So we need to register a custom setting. I don't know. Do I have any extension that already has that and I can just copy it? It's not very complicated to write a custom setting component, but if I can copy it, it would be better. But which extension might have that? I don't know. That's a text area, but it's not a simple setting. Don't even know if I have any here that has. No, so what you can see is that when you call register settings, that's not going to help. I need to find the definition. So when you call that, it will. Yeah, no, that's not helpful. Never mind. What I just want to do is replicate. So there is a function, I will just find it. There is a function called buildSettingsComponent, and that's what takes your settings definition and makes an input. And you can see inside of here there are some checks. So if your type is checkbox, boolean, switch, it will make a switch. If it is select dropdown, it will make that. And by default, it will just make a text input. But we need a text area. So basically, we'll rewrite this as a custom setting. And to make a custom setting, you can just call register setting with a function. And then inside of here, you can return a template. So I will just return form group. Inside of the form group, I will return a label. So the label will be this. Then we will have an input. The input will have... okay, so there is some logic above for that, I think. Not sure where the class name is added. Okay, so it's added here. So yeah, there is a class name on the input. Then, except it's not an input we want. We want the text area. And then here we will have value. I don't think it's using the bidirectional thing with this.setting. Yep. Like this. Yeah, and then there is also the help text. So let's just copy the help text. And here we will use the help text like. And here setting is the name of the setting, so the name of the setting is like this. Okay, so then I can remove this. But we have some warnings because we use TypeScript, so we need to fix those warnings. So one of the steps is that we actually do want the file that I didn't include earlier. So we want to have the shims.d.ts. Because that file tells TypeScript that the global M is Mitchell. So now we have a few less warnings. Now we just have the this warning, and that one we will fix by saying that this is extension page. We need to import extension page from Flarom admin components. Extension page. Like this, and there is still a warning here. So it's not because of so the warning was because a comma was missing. Okay. So now this should have become a text area. Let's see if it worked. Yes, it worked. There is that other problem, is that Flarom has custom styling to make the width limited, but it's based on the input. So we do need less after all. We need just a bit of we need a bit of less just to say that we want that to not go outside of the other stuff. So let's just find some. Basically, we want to do the same that. Where is it? Yes, error message here. So you can see here we have extension page settings, input max width 400 pixels. So basically, we want that, but with text area. But it's not a good idea to do it like this because now it will affect other extensions, and some other extensions might actually want that to not be like this. So what we can do here is only affect our own page. So we can do this by using this class that is added at the top of the extension settings page. And yeah, and maybe we can add a little comment, same max width as input. Okay, and then we can register that. So let's go back here. Let's do CSS and then import that from resources less admin.less. Okay. Yep, looks good. Now we can do the same for the blacklist. Blacklist will also be multi-line, and we can just copy this like this, remove that, and now the settings are looking good. So yeah. Now let's not use regular expressions for now. So let's say that example is whitelisted. I mean, it doesn't like if you use domain mode, it makes no sense to have whitelist and blacklist because obviously everything that isn't example.com will end up blacklisted. No, I mean if you decide to ban example.com, then what would you whitelist? Nothing, because you cannot whitelist individual addresses. But in regular expression mode, you could blacklist a lot of domains and then whitelist just a few specific addresses, for example. So yeah, so for now let's just do the non-blacklist, the non-regular expression, and adapt our code. So let's go back to the code. So now we will change this a bit because we need to do something different depending on whitelist or blacklist. I'm always saying the wrong thing. So regular expression, we will extract the settings. So get whether we want regular expression like this. Okay, then we will loop. How am I going to do this? So we will explode the settings. So we will explode the whitelist. Explode the whitelist as whitelisted. And then inside of here, we will do the check. So we will check if. So that's where there will be a difference, because either we will do. Hold on. So maybe I can call this line, because then I will just do a trim. So whitelisted, or maybe I can use expression, will be the trimmed version of line. The reason I use trim is because in case you have a space at the end, or if the new lines use something like if there is a carriage return inside of here, It will still be there, so trim will remove any carriage return that might be in the text. And then we will just run the expression through pregmatch, like this. Yep. And so, so regular expression needs to be here. Then we will check. So if we are in regex mode, we will do that. But otherwise, we will do we will explode by the at character and then compare what is after. Now the question is, how do we split by the character? I think we will use split. We'll use the explode. So the problem is that there might not be the at character, so we cannot just explode by at and take the second element, because there might be no second element. So we'll do it like this, and then if count of parts is greater than one, then we'll check the last one. So we'll check parts count. Technically, there should not be more than two, because there will be a validation for valid email. But yeah, no, not like this. Oh, I'm not splitting the correct thing. I need to split the value and then check if the last part of the value after the last at is expression. And then if that's the case, we return. And so that's how we will use returns to exit the validation. And if we are still there at the very end, we will throw the fail. So here, this is a whitelist. So if it matches, then we just return. Otherwise, we continue to the blacklist. So then, and that's where I think we will need to use a rule. Yeah, let's use a rule. So because I want to reuse the logic for this, I don't want to type this twice. So what we will do is create a new class called whitelist rule, and this class will implement the rule contract from Laravel. And that's one of the other ways to make a validation, is to do it like this. Create a custom class, and then I will move all of this to this. But there are a few things that change. So now the fail is no longer a fail function. Now it's something you need to return inside of message. And the other thing is that the settings, now I can actually resolve them through the constructor. So I can do it like this, because now there is a constructor, so I can use dependency injection. So protected settings, this settings equals settings. And now I can just do this settings, I can remove this, I can change this. Can do it like this, settings. Yes, okay. And now what I can do is use a function, so I can make a protected function. I don't know what I hear outside. how can I call this one? I will just call it check. or maybe passes. Let's call this like this, and then we will have value, expression, and whether it's a regular expression. Yes, the name cannot be you. Oh yeah, it's the same name, so. So yeah, we will do it like this, and now I will use the logic like this. This will return a boolean. Regex will also be a boolean. Expression. No, it's not like this. Regex will be a boolean. Expression needs to be a string. And value, we will not type in it because it might be null, it might be something else. Yeah, then expression. Yeah, let's just remove it like this. Then if it is regular expression and matches. Oh no, my logic was not correct. Let's do it like this. If it is a regular expression, then we do that. Otherwise, we do that. Okay. And now here what we can do, we can keep the loop as line expression equals trim line, and then we can do if this this dot check value expression regex, then we return early. Actually, we need to return true. What else do we need here? There was something. Yeah, we need to cast. We need to cast this to boolean, otherwise there might be errors. Okay, and then we can make another loop. The other loop will go through all of the blacklist. Then in the blacklist, if any of the line checks, then we will actually fail the thing. Wait, how do we do this now? What happens here? So does it pass or does it fail if we don't go through anything? That's another problem. So if you have a whitelist but no blacklist, we need to consider that everything is blacklisted. But if there is a blacklist, then anything that's not in the blacklist becomes whitelisted. So actually, we need. Yeah. Oh, and there is something else we need. We need to trim the value, because in case there is a new line at the end, we don't want an empty line. So let's just put the blacklist inside of here. Oh no, there is another problem, is that if there is just nothing in the list, we will still have just one line. So it's a bit more complicated than this. So the whitelist will be, so we trim everything just to make sure that we have no new lines, nothing, and we are just left with an empty string if there is nothing. And then we only do, we only loop. We don't need to do it like this. Because we want to ignore empty lines. That's the trick here. So we don't actually need to trim this. What we can do is, if there is an empty line, we will skip that line. So do not evaluate empty lines. Okay. Now it's a bit different with the blacklist, because the blacklist, if there is nothing in the blacklist, then we need to blacklist everything else. So that's why I do this first. First, I do the trim on the blacklist. And now, if there is no blacklist, if there is no blacklist, we automatically fail. If no blacklist is provided, fail all other values. Okay, like this. But if there is a whitelist, if there is a blacklist, why is it undefined? It's not backlist, it's blacklist. So then if there is a blacklist, then we will check the blacklist and fail. And if there was a blacklist but nothing failed, then we will succeed. And the error message will always be the same. It comes from here. Okay. And hi, Tedhan. Welcome to the stream. Yes, we are up to 4 people watching. So yeah, we are making the whitelist, email whitelist extension. And right now we are making a custom Laravel rule object that will take care of checking both the whitelist and blacklist. And the blacklist can be evaluated as either just a regular expression or it will just evaluate the email domain. So yeah, and now we need to use that rule instead of what we had previously here. So then we can actually just drop all of this. And then it just becomes resolve the whitelist rule. And we use resolve and not new, because that way the constructor parameters will be resolved by Flahoma, and in more specifically the container. So yeah, let's see if it still works. So right now we just have one whitelist. So let's try this again. Try to sign up. So we see there is no warning for the email. But if I use the wrong domain, yeah, there is. But now let's do... So as I said, it doesn't make much sense. But you can see here, if I had... let's say the second domain is flahom.org. So for example, if I forbid flahom.org and example.com, but whitelist example.com, so yeah, that doesn't really make sense, you can see, when we are not in regular expression mode. But yeah, but so you can see that anything else is actually valid. So how can I... Maybe we need to update the text. Here, one expression per line. If a blacklist is provided, everything not listed will be whitelisted. And then we can keep the will have priority over the blacklist. Okay, let's keep it like this. So yeah. What did I want? Yeah, so oh yeah, I wanted to test. So example.com should pass, but flahom.org shouldn't, based on how it's done. Okay, so that seems to work. Now if we switch to regular expression, now it should... Okay, so there is an error. We can see something went wrong. So it's not supposed to show errors. What's happening? Pregmatch delimiter must not be alphanumeric or backslash. So yeah, that's because the regular expression is invalid. Don't think we will make anything special for that. That's what is said here. Switch from domain list to regular expression check. Each line of the list must be a valid regular expression with delimiters. And that's why there is an error. That's because the expression are not valid here. So let's just switch back to the whitelist and just add at example.com as the only whitelist. Let's try this again. So now it doesn't work anymore. And if I do example.com, that works. Yeah. And now you can see that I can do some magic here. So for example, if I wanted to allow any number after example something.com, I could. Or maybe that's what I can do. I can put, for example, so for example, I can blacklist everything from example with any number.com, but I can whitelist I can whitelist example42.com. So that's not that useful to have both of them at the same time, but yeah, you can if you really want to. So now example 2 is blacklisted. Example is not blacklisted because it has no number, but yeah, so any number is blacklisted except 42. Example 42 is not blacklisted. Okay, so we are pretty much done, I think. Don't need anything else. Yeah, maybe one thing I could do is error message. The email is not okay. So what I want to do is, yeah, if you don't provide an error message, what happens? Well, this happens. Oh, so it defaults to the name of the validation rule. So what we will do is provide a default translation in case there is none. So we will do a new namespace here. It will just be called API, and it will be just message. Maybe we can call it default message, or maybe not default, fallback. Fallback message. How are we going to call this? The email is invalid, and I think we'll just use a very generic error message because yeah, most of the time I think this will be customized. It doesn't make much. I mean, if you whitelist your emails, most likely you will want to customize the error message to be very user friendly. However, if you blacklist some emails, I'm not even sure what you might want to say, because you might want to edit the message to be a get out, or I don't. We could have a different error message if you fail the whitelist versus if you fail the blacklist. But I think most people will just use one of the two, so there is no real need. So yeah, let's just use the email is invalid and use that as the fallback. So if the value here is empty string, then we will default to resolve. Yeah, I don't know. No, let's not use resolve. Let's do the things properly. Let's resolve the translator from here. So translator, let's put the translator on settings, put it there, and then here we can do this translator get, or we can use trans, and here we can use the name of the translation. Dot API dot fallback message, like this. So now if you have not provided something, it will just say the email is invalid. But I think that might be confusing, because if people see that error message, they might not be sure from which extension it comes. So maybe it's better that we put the email did not pass the whitelist. Or maybe is blacklisted. Is not whitelisted. Let's just put the email is not whitelisted. That way, if you see that error, you are pretty sure that it comes from this extension. And then you know that you can customize. the error message, and maybe the error message we will call it custom error message, so it's a bit more friendly. Okay. Yeah, and if we use regular expressions when we are not in regular expression mode, then you are going to have some issues, because of course the email will not pass, even if you, because it will check literally if the domain is that string, which will never be the case. Oh, something we can also test is that, just check that the modifiers work. So if I just go back to example.com, but if we say that I want so to allow uppercase, now we can, but if I didn't have the I modifier, then we couldn't. So yeah. Okay, I think we are good with that. Let me know if there is anything else you wanted to see. So we took about 1 hour to do that one. Now we will do the second one, which is about username blacklisting, and it will be the same basically. So yeah, is there something else I need to do here? I will just check if there is any more cleanup that is necessary. I don't think so. I think that's pretty good. So what we will do is copy paste that extension. So yeah, there might be some merit into making this into a single extension, but yeah, FlaHome is flexible, so that in the sense that extensions are really how we design things. So I think it's a lot better to make a second extension, and there will be one noticeable difference is that we will not validate domain by default. We will validate the full username. So FlaHome ext username blacklist. Here we will again delete ID. Yeah, I think that's all we needed to do. Yep, and here we can also just keep it like it was. Okay, perfect. Next, let's switch to the new project. So let's go to username, blacklist, open in the same window, that's fine. Okay, now let's change, so it will be username, blacklist. Oh, I didn't change the description on the other, so blacklist or whitelist specific usernames. Then this one will be username, validation. Let's put blacklist first, because why not? Username, blacklist, let's do it like this. Username, blacklist. Username, blacklist. I don't know if I will just keep the same same icon. I think it's fine. Next, I can update the namespace. Here, I can update the namespace here. So then basically everything will be the same, just renamed. So for now, I will just rename everything that is called email whitelist with username blacklist. So now the JavaScript, like this. And now here, rename this. Yeah, I could do a search and replace, but now it's too late. I'm too deep in. I need to finish doing it manually. So yeah, one difference now is that, so we will put the blacklist first. Oh, and do we want to change the order of the priority? Do we want to make the blacklist priority? No, it doesn't really make sense, because Then why would you use the two together if blacklist had priority? Then whitelist would never be used together. So yeah, we'll put the blacklist first just because it's the one you will probably most use, but it will still work the same technically. Yeah, everything else will stay the same here. Next, what else? Yeah, the translations and the what happened there? So we will rename the custom CSS and also the translations here. So we'll have okay, let's change the order of the thing to match with one expression per line. If a blacklist is provided, everything not listed will be whitelisted. Yeah, but that's pretty much, that's very logical. I will change the text to be the opposite. So if no blacklist is provided, everything not whitelisted will be rejected. But it still actually works the same as the other extension. That's just another way of saying it. Yeah, and then the username is not whitelisted will be the fallback message. Okay, and now what else? We need to customize this a bit. So validation. What? Oh, it's PHP 8. Why is this one PHP 8 and the other one wasn't? No, we are PHP 7.3. Okay. Yeah. So, what do we change here? We'll still do the whitelist first. And then the blacklist. Yeah, the only difference is here, is that if we are not in regex mode, then the logic is just whether the whole value equals the expression. That's the difference. So it's even simpler. Like this. So yeah, there is still a lot of duplicated code between the two extensions, but we will keep it like this. And now the last thing we need to change is here, because now it's no longer email, it's username that we want to validate. And yeah, I think that's it. Let's maybe just change the icon. Still, I want to use another icon because otherwise they will all have the same thing. I think I will use this one. I like, or maybe the AB. Oh, maybe the spell check icon might be. Let's use that one. Spell check. Maybe I could use that icon for the other one as well. Nah, let's do it like this. Yeah, now let's install this extension. So composer require username blacklist. And something else we need to do is to compile. So I was still in the other folder. Let's go to the flarom.ext username blacklist and run yarn dev. Go back to Flarom. Okay, now let's find the username blacklist. Yeah, maybe we should have used something with a cross. don't think there is the same icon. Yeah, the icon with the spell check but with the cross will be nice, but yeah, we don't have it, so we have to do with what is available. We don't have time to make new icons. So it's very similar to the other extension, so let's just check. Oh, one more thing that is interesting is that if we leave this empty, I think we are locked. If you leave both of them empty, then nothing will work, because everything not whitelisted will be blacklisted if no blacklist is provided. So that means that, yeah, if it's empty, you are done. But that's not the problem, you just disable the extension if you don't want it. So yeah, now let's blacklist some usernames. So obviously it's not really useful to blacklist usernames that are already registered. So maybe let's just ban moderator, let's ban administrator. So there is already a user named admin, so it's not really interesting. What's funny is that all the usernames I can think of are actually usernames that some people use on the Discus server. I think there is someone called God on the Discus server. We do have a blacklist on Discus, but it's not with an extension. It's manually done with the local extender. What else can we blacklist? I mean, that's fine. Let's just try this. So let's just try to do this. So now you can see that the is working. Maybe let's just use a valid email so that we have one less warning. Okay, so now let's try to call ourselves moderator. You can see the username is not whitelisted. I had an ID here. I wanted to maybe default to the same error message as when a username is taken. I didn't know if that was a good idea if we could just say that the username is already taken, so that you don't suspect that there is a whitelist in place. But then again, if someone is troubleshooting problems, then they will be confused, because why does it tell that the username is taken, but instead it's their whitelist? So I think we will keep it like this. If you, because what happens if the username is taken? So you can see it says the username has already been taken. So if you want to mask the fact that you are using a whitelist, you can use this as a validation message. And people will have no way of telling the difference because the validation is done in the backend. All they see is the text. So if you do this, it says the username has already been taken. And if we check the network tab, you can see that there is nothing in here that's different between the username actually being taken and not really being taken. So you can use the same error message, and that way you will disguise the fact that the username is blocked. But you might also want to use another strategy, like good try. I'm thinking of something now. Do we want to make it, we might want to make it case insensitive, because if you do that, it works. And we need to do the same for the email. I think we need to do the same for the email because people will expect the email to be case insensitive. So I'm not actually sure how we do a check without a regular expression. So PHP case insensitive. descriptive comparison. How do we do case insensitive? Oh yeah, we can just call it. Yeah, let's use str to lower. Oh yeah. Do we want to do that by default, or do we need an option to enable or disable the case? I mean, most use case you will want to be the, you will want the check to be case insensitive. So, and if you don't want it to be case insensitive, then you will very likely already use a regular expression. So yeah, we should probably just do case insensitive by default when it's not regular expression. So let's do str to lower value equals str to lower expression, and we will need to do the same in the other extension. So let's go back to email, let's open this one in a new window, go back here. Now here we will do str to lower of the last part, which was the domain, compared with str to lower expression. Yeah. Yep. Okay, I think that will be better like this, so that, yeah. Now it says good try. So that's pretty much it. See, the second extension only took 15 minutes, since it's just a big copy paste of the other extension. What else is there to be done? I don't think there is much else. Do you have any question, any suggestion? What I can do now is update the README. So let's just do the README. So email whitelist. So I will rename everything that said bookmarks. Now we need to say flarum.ext email whitelist. Replace all. This extension will be on minimal maintenance. Sponsors, well, there are no sponsors, it's done for the live stream, so I will just remove this like this. We need to create the discussions. We'll do that soon. So add a little description, this extension. Allows whitelisting or blacklisting email addresses with regular expression mode disabled. Only the domain is validated in regular expression mode. Full address is checked against the regular expression. And here we can specify that it's using PHP preg match function. The regular expression must include delimiters and can include modifiers. Okay, something like this. Maybe we can also add here that's a full the order. So if no blacklist is defined, everything not whitelisted will be rejected. If a blacklist is defined, every whitelisted value as well as value. How can we say this? That every as well as values not matched by the blacklist will be accepted. The validation error message can be customized. So yeah, the extension allows whitelisting or blacklisting email addresses with regular expression mode disabled. Only the domain is validated. In regular expression mode, the full address is checked against the regular expression using PHP pragmatch function. Regular expression must include delimiters and can include modifiers. If no blacklist is defined, everything not whitelisted will be rejected. If a blacklist is defined, every whitelisted value as well as values not matched by the blacklist will be accepted. Validation error message can be customized in the settings. I think that's okay. Let's do the same for the other extension. So copy paste this. Now this one is called username blacklist. Here we can also rename this so it becomes flarom_x username blacklist. Replace all, remove the sponsors for the old extension. This, in the other extension, I also needed to update the description. So, this one will be whitelist or blacklist specific email addresses by domain or regex. I expected to hear fireworks, but instead I hear people crying outside. I don't know what is happening. So the username blacklist readme. So yeah, this extension allows, we just do it in the blacklisting or whitelisting usernames. I'm wondering something. So the interesting part about how the extension is implemented is that it actually works not only during registration, in case you didn't know. So it also works when you change email. So if you want to see, so if I go to my profile and decide to change email, and I want to do it like this, you see, it will also error when you try to change email because Flarom uses the same validator behind the scenes. So the way we implemented it, it will work everywhere. Except now I'm wondering, there is an extension by Friends of Flarom, which allows requesting new usernames, and I'm wondering if it's using the same validation or not. Create request. Yeah, so there is a class. So let's just check if this will use the same validator. Assert. I think it will work. Yeah, it's using So we can see this extension is also using the user validator, and then it's passing an attribute named username. So the username blacklist should also apply to this extension. So you will not be able to request anything from the blacklist using the friends of LaRome extension. So yeah, that's good as well. So this extension allows blacklisting or whitelisting usernames with regular expression mode disabled. Maybe we can change this text. So, oh yeah, we can add the fact that it's case insensitive. In default mode, the list the provided username is checked against the list. How do we say that in English? In a case insensitive way? Or without case? Is in how do we say that? In default mode, the username is checked against the list in a case insensitive way. Okay, it's not written correctly. Case insensitive. Oh, it's just a dash. In a case insensitive. Or maybe we can do this differently. In default mode, a case insensitive check is done with provided username against the list. In regular expression mode, full username is checked against the regular expression using PHP pragmatch function. Regular expression must include delimiters and can include modifiers. If no blacklist is defined, everything not whitelisted will be rejected. If a blacklist is defined, every whitelisted value as well as values not matched by the blacklist will be accepted. We will keep that text the same, and the validation error message can be customized in the settings. That's also still true. I think that's it. What else is there to do? Don't know. Yeah, I think we are pretty good. What we can do is run yarn build to make the production. Production file. Yeah, and then we can do the same in the other one, flarome ext email whitelist yarn build. And yeah, can I show you? So we still have some time and we still have people watching, so I guess I can show you how I will publish the extension, because yeah, I will not do anything else. So I will publish the extension, show you how that works. I just need to make sure that I don't accidentally show some stuff that you don't need to see. The next step is to put the repositories on GitHub. So GitHub, new repository, and then here we can create them. So flarome ext, and we will call the first one email whitelist. Then the description, we will copy the description from this. It will be a public repository. Let's create this. Then we can add this to here. So in the, so first we'll do email whitelist, so we can call git init to initialize git. then we can add the origin, then we can rename the branch. Oh no, we cannot do that until we made the commit. So, oh yeah, we could do this actually when we don't have any commit yet. But yeah, so yeah, I need to make the commit. Now what I'm going to do is I want to have the discuss link inside of the extension on the first commit. So what I will do is actually create the discussions in advance. So yeah, so we will do everything in quick succession. So I open everything here. I'm not sure if... No, I think I can show you this, no problem. So I will do things in quick succession. So I will create the discussion on discuss in the extension tag. Then I will push the GitHub repository. Then I will create the packagist package. And yeah, I will do all that just one after the other, so that yeah, people might see the post just before it's actually published, but that's not a big problem. You are kind of a champion if you manage to try to install the extension right before I finish publishing it. So I copy the readme, then I will add the title, then I publish this email whitelist. You can see there is a warning here, the packagist was not found. Then I can copy the ID, I can put it here, I can put it here, and I can put it here. Okay, next I can do the next step, so I can do git add everything. Then I can do a git status, check that I have everything I want inside the extension, and also that I don't have anything I don't want. But yeah, I don't expect any issue here. So yeah, that looks fine. So I can do git commit, just name this one first commit, and then I can use other commands here. So I can rename the branch main, and I can push the main branch to GitHub. And here we go. Last thing I can do is make a release. So let's make a release. I will do it from GitHub 1.0.0 first release. It's not written correctly. Release. Initial release. Let's name it initial release. Publish, and now I can copy this, register the package on packagist. Package name found is Clark Flaromex whitelist submit. And we are good to go. In a few minutes, people can already install the extension. Pretty good. And when I say a few minutes, it means it's already done. Yeah. Perfect. Yeah, looks good. There's really not much special. It's a really simple extension. Yeah, now let's do the same for the other one. Let's see, I just want to make sure that... Yeah, I change... Oh, how can I do this? Yeah, I can go in the post. Yeah, okay, yeah, I just want... I don't want to go back to the homepage of Flarom because then you see some discussions that might not be visible to everyone. So if I just make a new discussion now, let's go and copy paste the other file. So now it's username blacklist. Copy this, put on username blacklist, publish, copy the ID. Put the ID there, put the ID here and here, perfect. Next, go back to flahom ext username blacklist, git init, git add everything. Whoops, what's happening? File exists? What? Did I... What's happening here? Git add? Oh, okay, now it's working. Okay, not sure what was going on. So admin... Oh no, there is a mistake. There is a mistake. I didn't delete the dist files. So there is still the forum.js of the old extension because... So let's just do this properly. Let's just delete the dist and run dev again. So it will not prevent the extension from working. It's just that there is a dist. There is a dist file that is not supposed to be there. So it's supposed to be just admin. So we'll need to go and remove it from the other extension. Yeah, there just needs to be the admin dist file. Yeah, everything else looks good. Git commit, first commit. Then we can create the repository, flahom ext username blacklist. We can also copy the description from here. If I manage to go back to the correct window. Okay, create repository, copy the commands, username blacklist, add remote, switch to branch main, and push branch main. Okay, refresh. Make a first release, create release 1.0.0, initial release, copy paste, add this, publish release, perfect, now copy repository, go back to packages, submit another package, let's hope I don't get throttled or banned from packages for submitting too many packages. Don't think I'm anywhere close to a limit, if there is any. And yeah! I see there is already a watcher, but I guess it's just me that, yeah, it's automatically watching this. Okay, so now let's just fix the problem with the other extension. CD flahom ext email whitelist. Okay, so here what we need to do is just go back to email whitelist. I mean, I could just delete the admin, the forum.js, but just to be safe, I delete the whole folder, run yarn build again. And then here I can do git status, git add, git status, git commit, remove. Leftover files. I don't really need to tag a new release for that because yeah, those files will just be there completely unused. They will not be exposed to the web because they will just be in the vendor folder. So yeah, it's not worth tagging a new release. And I mean, it would be a problem if I had some leftover files from another extension for which I do not have the license, because then I would have code that is incorrectly licensed in my extension. But here it's just code made by me, so there is really no concern of any kind. Yeah, there is just some unwanted code inside of the bundle, but it's not used. So yeah, perfect. Now if we refresh the little packages badges should work, but I mean it takes some time because I think where is it? I wanted to, okay, here.
Yeah, the little links to show the status. GitHub does not refresh them often, so yeah. Oh, what happens if I refresh the page here? I don't even know. With the side navigation. Oh yeah, it just closes. Okay, but we can see it's still not, the little badges still don't show. They still don't show up, but they should show up at some point. It's just something with the cache. Okay, and I see I get some likes, so okay, some people have already liked. Maybe it's who is watching the stream who knows that those extensions were coming. Okay, so yeah, we are pretty much done. The extensions are on GitHub. They are on minimal maintenance, but I don't expect them to break until Flarom 2.0. So yeah, they should be good to go for a while. And if anyone wants to add some more advanced features, you can always contact me and we can discuss how much work that might be. But yeah, if I go back, is the other one still open? Email. Whitelist. Yeah, I have my new commit. Okay. So I think we will stop there. Oh, and now we are down to one person watching live. So yeah, that's a sign that it's the end, I guess. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this stream. So maybe you can understand why on the forums I say that sometimes some things are too easy. It's like, yeah, if someone contacted me to make this extension, it will not take as long because I'm a lot quicker if I'm not doing the live stream. So that extension will probably have just taken half an hour or less. So that's why sometimes I don't like when people need so extensions so simple that it's so little work. And then, so yeah, that's why I usually ask for if I work with someone to have something that takes at least 2 hours. So it might be multiple extensions or just one big extension. Yeah, but it's a good subject for a live stream like this one. And yeah, it's a really simple extension, I think. We added a few more complex things with regular expression switch and the ability to have blacklist and whitelist at the same time. But you could make an even simpler extension by having just the whitelist and no other options. You could even hard code the error message. The error message, we could also have just use a translation and you could have customized the translation using the linguist extension. But yeah, I figured it was better to do it like this because, yeah. Particularly for the email validation, it's very likely that you will want to customize it. For the username, it's less likely. We could have hard-coded a default generic message. Yeah, but for email, usually, I mean, you will use it for if you use it for whitelisting, then you will probably say, please use the domain from your company or use the domain from your school or something like that. Yeah. So, oh, we didn't check again the I changed the email to be case insensitive, but we didn't check that again, did we? I hope it works correctly. Sign up. Do we still have, so what is the configuration right now? Email whitelist. So if we disable regular expression but use just example.com, what happens? Or yeah, if we just whitelist example.com and if I manage to find back the browser, okay. Now if I do test at example.com, yeah, so it's taken, but okay, so that one is valid, but now if I put it uppercase. Okay, it works. Okay, because previously that would have been rejected. Okay. All good. So, let's switch back to the full screen. Yeah. So this time, I don't even need to tell you that the extensions will be on GitHub soon. They are already available. You can install them. So that will be all for today's stream. If you have ideas for next streams or questions, suggestions, just let me know in the comments or on the forum. And yeah, I will try to find some other ideas for extensions, and we will continue to do every Sunday. For now, nothing prevents me from doing the live stream, so I will continue to do them when possible. So yeah, thanks for joining in, and I will see you next time. Bye.